for Jesus. Praise the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. I'm for the Rock Intercessor Ministries. I'm here to preach to you today the word of Jesus Christ, hoping that some of you give your life to God today. Happy New Year, everybody. Now, my message for you is what? Is the Holy Spirit. Do you know who the Holy Spirit is? Do you know that Holy Spirit is a person? One person, the third person of God. You have God the Father, who is the creator and the superior God, the ruler of all things, and then have the God, the Savior, Jesus Christ, my Lord and personal Savior, your Lord and personal Savior, and then you have God, the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. And the God, the Holy Spirit, come to the world to empower us, to help us to do what? For us to know God. Amen. For us to live a righteous life. And that is why today I'm here to preach to you. For you to live a Christian life, for you to live a holy life, a righteous life, it's going to be impossible for you to live it without the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And that is why I pray through the word of God that God will touch your heart through his word, through the ministry of the Holy Spirit, that you receive Jesus Christ today as your Lord and personal Savior. Now, listen to what Jesus Christ said in the book of John 14, verse 15. Jesus Christ speaking. He said, if you love me, you will keep my commandments. Amen. So that means God wants you to love him. And if you love him, you have to keep his commandment. There's no point you calling him Lord, 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 and you don't keep his commandment. In fact, the Bible said this, that on the last day, you can call him Lord, but if you don't keep commandment, he's going to say, you go behind me, you workers of what? Iniquities. You see, that's why the Bible is saying today to do what? To love God, and if you love him, you keep his commandment. And then he says, because you love him, keep his commandment, he will ask the Father. Remember, I told you, you have three God, you have three persons, one God. So you have God the Father, you have God the Son, you have the God the Holy Spirit. And now he said that you're going to ask God the Father, and he will give you another helper. Amen. Another helper. And that helper is the Holy Spirit. And then he said, the Spirit of the truth. So that means he tells you the truth. It doesn't lie to you. He said the world cannot receive it. So that means if you are in the world and you are living in the world, one thing about world, if you move away from the principle, if you move away from the principle and the prospect of God and the law of God, you start living your own, doing his own thing, that means you are in the world. The Bible says you cannot receive this Holy Spirit. Why? Because you never see him, nor you know him. He said, but those who believe in him, who have kept his commandment, he said, you know him, and because he dwells in you. So if God dwells in you, that means you know God. Because God dwells in me, I know God, that means I have to obey him and keep his commandment. And then he said that if he dwells in you, and he said he will not leave you as an orphan, and he said he will come to you. So that means me and you can never accuse God of child neglect. Amen. If he obey God, in fact, the Bible says this in the book of John chapter 1, verse 13. He said, if you receive God and if you believe in him, he said he will give you right to be called the children of God. So that means God only gives right to those who believe in him, who have obeyed him, and that is when he gives you the gift of the Holy Spirit. And that is what I'm telling you today. The Holy Spirit is a deposit in your life. Just as you go to a shop, you deposit something, and you can come back and pay for it and collect it later. The same way the Holy Spirit's been deposited in my life, in your life, on the day of redemption. Without the Holy Spirit, you cannot see God. Amen. You don't know God because you don't know him. And if you don't know him, you can't receive him. You see? And that's why it pains me so much, because some of you don't know who God is. You see, some of you don't have the gift of the Holy Spirit. It is a gift. The Bible says if you ask God, but there's a condition that comes to that. The Bible says if you obey him, amen, if you obey his commandment, if you love God, the Bible says if you ask him, he will give you the gift of the Holy Spirit, you see. And that is why I'm telling you today to do what? To give your life to Jesus Christ, you see. Because our God never fails us. God loves us so much that he has to deposit his spirit in us, you see. And this brings me to my topic today. I want to give you the 9 works of the Holy Spirit, you see. So the first one here, the Bible says in the book of John chapter 16, verse 8, just Christ speaking, he says, when he comes, talking about the Holy Spirit, he will convince the world concerning sin, righteousness, and judgment. So these are the work of the Holy Spirit. One Holy Spirit, 3 words. He said he will do what? Convict you of your sins. Amen. So that means if you are living a sinful lifestyle, you know that feeling that you have, you think it's a feeling, it's a Holy Spirit telling you to do what? To stop sinning. And then he's saying, I lead you to righteousness. So that means the Holy Spirit will lead you to do what? To live a righteous life. Mean rightly standing before God. Amen. So that means you are doing the thing God wants you to do. And then he said he will do what? He will bring judgment. So that means you can judge not to sin. Amen. You can say to yourself, I don't have to follow this person to go and get drunk. I don't have to follow this person to go and sleep around. I don't have to follow these people to go and smoke weed. You see, so the Holy Spirit will do what? Will come and guide you. You see, so you don't have to do all these evil things. You don't have to do all these sin. You don't have to do all this wicked way of life, you see. And that is one of the work of the Holy Spirit. But have three functions. And then the second work of the Holy Spirit is to do what? In the book of Ephesians chapter 1 verse 13, Paul said that in him, that is Jesus Christ, you also, when you have heard the word of the truth, the gospel of your salvation, and believe in him, you were sealed with the promise of the Holy Spirit. So that is why I'm telling you, you are not on your own, you are the property of God. Because now God have sealed you, and if God sealed you, and what God gives is irrevocable, nobody can unseal you. Amen. If you are being saved, nobody, if you're only going to be saved once, when people think sometimes they're being saved and then they lose their salvation, no way, it is impossible. What God has sealed, nobody can break it. You can try. Devil can try. Devil cannot break you. Does it mean you might not go and sin? God bless you. Can I help you, sir?
Yes. That guy told me your wife is Hungarian.
Yeah, my yes.
Me Hungarian as well.
See, yeah, hodgepodge. my best look, yo. I'm preaching now, okay?
Thank you.
Come and speak to you later, okay? So that's what I'm trying to tell you here today. Because if you give your life to Jesus Christ, our God is faithful enough to do what? To see you. Amen. When you see you, devil cannot break you. Sickness can come, they can't break you. Poverty can come, they can't break you. Nobody can break you. I can break you. Why? Because you are being sealed. And if God see you, he's been sealed. It's been sealed. It's irrevocable. Nobody can break you. You see? And that is why I'm telling you that you now belongs to Jesus Christ. Amen? And that is brings me to the third work of the Holy Spirit. Do you know that Holy Spirit dwells in you? Do you know that Holy Spirit dwells in me? Do you know that Holy Spirit dwells in us? Listen to what the Bible says in the book of Romans chapter 8 verse 11. It says, if the Spirit of him, talking about Jesus Christ, who have risen Jesus Christ from death, dwells in you, he also who risen Jesus Christ from death will also give your life to your mortal bodies through the Spirit who dwells in you. Hallelujah. So that means Holy Spirit come and dwell in my life and give you me the same power. You know, when Jesus Christ died, the Holy Spirit come and waking him. The same Holy Spirit, when I die, God bless you, Happy New Year. When I die, this Holy Spirit God will do what? Awaken me as well. So that means there's a power. Amen. There's a power that is in you. And the same power I can tell you to do what? To say no to sin. And that is why I'm telling you today, see, because you are not a divine child of God, you are not property of God, and now you are not cannot continue to live in sin. Why? Because now you have power to say no to sin. The Bible says that salvation and the grace of God appeared to all men, giving us the grace. So that means you are not disgraced to grace. It's giving you grace to say no to sin, giving you the ability to say no to sin. Why? Because you have the gift of the Holy Spirit and he's dwelling in you. That means it's in you. So that means everywhere I go, Holy Spirit is with me. You see? So that means Holy Spirit will tell you not to go to pub. Holy Spirit will tell you not to go to nightclub. Holy Spirit will tell you not to go and get drunk. You see, so now because now you have power to say no to sin, and that is what I'm telling you today. This brings me toward the fourth work of the Holy Spirit. Do you know that Holy Spirit is the best teacher? Amen. You go to school, you have your teacher, they teach you about the ethnic things, they can never teach you about the spiritual things, about God. They can never teach you to say no to sin. They can try, they'll continue to fail. That is why you continue going back to your sin. Listen to what the Bible says in the book of John 14 verse 26. He said, but the helper, that's the Holy Spirit, when the Father will send in my name, that's the name of Jesus Christ, he will teach you all things and bring to your remembrance all things that I have said to you. Hallelujah. Just think about it, you see. Holy Spirit will come and teach you to do what? In this difficult life that we are living, in this sinful world, no matter any circumstances that you are going through, Holy Spirit will come and do what? To guide you, to teach you. Amen. You put it in this way. I have children. God bless you. Happy New Year. I have children. I teach them good things. Because why? I love them the same way God come to do what? To teach us. Amen. If you accept the gift of the Holy Spirit, he'll come and teach you. He'll become your best teacher. You know, we need teacher in this life. In football match, I used to play football. You have a coach. He coach you how to play. Sometimes you go too much offside. He stay to somewhere. You need to time your timing. He's teaching you. And you listen to him. The same way you go to school, you listen to your teacher. The same way you're at home, you listen to your parents. The same way God is your heavenly Father. He's telling you why he need the Holy Spirit, because Holy Spirit will teach you to say no to the earthly things. Honestly, we lead you to the righteous life, to the holy life, to the Christian life that God wants you to live. You see, and now this brings me to the feet of work of the Holy Spirit. Do you know that Holy Spirit gives us fruit? Amen. Do you know there's a fruit that is in the Holy Spirit? Now listen to what the Bible says in the book of Galatians chapter 5 verse 22. It says the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. He said against such things there's no law. So that means you need the fruit of the Holy Spirit. You see, are you not a lovely person? The Bible says, even though you have reason to hate, the Bible says love. Why? Because God loves you. Amen. God loves you to the point whereby he sent his son. For God so loved the world that he sent his son, that whoever believes in him will not perish, but do what we live, will have eternal life. So that means God loves us and he gives us love. And if you don't have love, that means you don't know God. Because the Bible says God is love. The Bible says that you should love God with all your heart, with your strength, with your soul, with your mind. And then you should love yourself, your neighbor before yourself. So you are in the third order in picking of things. You are number three. Number one is God. The second person is your neighbor. And then the third person is yourself. Amen. So that means you love God, you love your neighbor, you love yourself. Amen. So there's no point you hating yourself. There's no point you hating other person. There's no point you hating God. Amen. Because these are the one of the fruit of the Spirit. And they talk about joy. So that means you have a joy like a river. That means when you are sick, you still have joy. The Bible says in all circumstances, he said what? Rejoice. Hallelujah. Amen. And then you're talking about peace. The Bible says the peace of God that he gives that passes every understanding. So that means people can never figure you out. Nobody can figure me out now. Do you know why? Because I have the peace of God. You cannot know that peace only when you know God. And then you're talking about what? Patience. So that means sometimes when people hate you and you meet impatient person, then you have the fruit of the Spirit. You have patience to bear with them. You see, because we are in a journey. Some of us are 100 yards ahead of us. Some of us are 100 yards lacking behind. Some of us in the middle. Some of us are just waking up from the sleep. You see, so now you have the spirit of the patient to bear patient with them, you see. And then talk about kindness and goodness. These are like twins. If you don't have kindness, you can never have goodness. If you have goodness, you need to have kindness, you see. So these two goes together, amen. Are you a kind person? You see, are you a rude person? You need to repent today, you see. Because you have the spirit of kindness, you will show kindness to others, you will show goodness to others, you will show them goodness. Because why? Our God is a good God. And then you're talking about faithfulness. Are you faithful to your wife or to your husband? Are you faithful to God? You know that our God is a faithful God. The Bible says our God is so faithful that he can never deny himself, even though when we are unfaithful to him, he's still faithful. You see? And that is why the Bible said that because we are sinners, the Bible said God still loves us. While we're still sinners, he sent his son. So what a wonderful God that we are serving. And that is, this brings me to gentleness. Are you a gentle person? You see? If you don't have gentleness in you, you need to repent. You see? You need to be gentle. That's one of the fruit of the Spirit. And talk about self-control. You see, many people today, they're out of control. Because why? They don't have control in their life. What are you going to do when somebody that you are living with or your friends, maybe your church member, out of control? Then you need the Spirit of God to control you. You see, and that is why I'm telling you, you see, all these fruits are delicious fruits and they have aroma. So that means when you are living a Christian life, people can see the aroma and see the fragrance coming out of you. Because why? You have the fruit of the Spirit, you see. So this brings me to number six, work of the Holy Spirit. Do you know that the Holy Spirit reminds us about things? Listen to what the Bible says in the book of John 14, verse 26. It says, the helper, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send to you in my name, he will teach you all things and bring them to your remembrance. All things. So that means that nothing will escape you. You have to remember this. These 12 disciples, they were with God. They saw the miracle. They saw Jesus Christ making the blind to see, made the cripple to walk. Hear all this. They see the greatest miracle. They saw Jesus Christ walk on water. They saw Jesus Christ cast out demons. They saw Jesus Christ raising the dead. They saw Jesus Christ feeding 5,000. They saw Jesus Christ walk on water. They saw Jesus Christ turn the tongue. They even saw Jesus Christ transfigure in their face. They saw Jesus. They hear the word. They hear the voice of God. In all these things, Jesus Christ said to them to do what? To remain in Jerusalem until you receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. You have to realize this. In those days, people don't have a computer, notepad, iPad, you name it. They don't have iPhone. They don't have all these things. You see, and there's a reason why God tell them to wait. Because why? He wants to bring all these things that have seen him perform. Even in front of their eyes, they saw him going to heaven. And still, he's telling them to stay in a closed room until you receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Without the gift of the Holy Spirit, it is impossible for you to remember all things. That is why the gift of the Spirit brings everything to remembrance to us. And that is why I'm telling you today. It's one of the work of the Holy Spirit. You need the Holy Spirit. God bless you. Amen. And that's why today, if you don't have the gift of the Spirit, you can never remember a baptism of God. That's why you see many people, they're going on their own way. They're like a car out of control, and they're on cruise control. And then they don't remember that it's God. Why? Because they don't have the gift of the Holy Spirit, you see. And now this brings me to my seventh point, the seventh work of the Holy Spirit. Now, the 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 8 says that, to one that is given the spirit of wisdom, knowledge, faith, healing, miracle, prophecy, spirit of discernment, speaking in tongues, interpretation of tongues, in all this is to do what? To empower you. From one, the same spirit. Amen. You need wisdom. The Bible says in the book of James chapter 1, if you lack wisdom, if you ask God, he will give you. But then don't be double-minded when you ask God. And then the Bible said knowledge. The Bible said that my people perish because of lack of knowledge. So that means you are perishing because why? You don't have the knowledge of God. But if you ask God today, he will give it to you. And another one is faith. Amen. People talk about faith, move mountains. No, Jesus Christ move mountains. You need Jesus Christ. If I just Christ say that you have faith that move mountains, but you don't have the faith to do what? To move malice. You see, and that is what I'm telling you today. You need the faith of God. Amen. You need the faith of God. Because the Bible says faith is a substance of things that we not see, evidence of things that you hope for. So that means when someone come and tell you, this is going to be like this, he said, a person, even I don't see it, I believe that God is going to do it. Because now you have the gift of God, which is called faith. And then talking about healing, do you know that Jesus Christ heals? I can pray for somebody, touch their hand right now, and they get healed. It doesn't matter what sickness is, we are serving a merciful God. We are serving a healing God. The Bible says in the book of Acts that everywhere he go, he was doing good. A mighty healer. He made the crippled to walk. He made the blind to see. He made that man to come back to life. What a wonderful God that we are serving. You talk about miracle. God perform miracles. We see God walk on water. We see God calm the storm. Amen. God came back. The biggest miracle is me preaching to you today. Amen. You want to see miracle? I am the miracle. Hallelujah. I am the miracle. God, working God of just Christ. I couldn't come here 3 years ago. Why? Because I could have known better, but I don't know. Because why God has transformed me, and that is why God moved me from dirty and cleansed me up. That is why I'm a miracle working, living person, because God has transformed me. Amen. And then talking about prophecy, what a wonderful God. The Bible says he never leaves his children in darkness. So that means God can tell you something's going to happen in the future. What a wonderful God. Some people still think those are the past. No, it's still happening. Christ visited me. I know this. I know it. You know, whether you want to believe or not, that's your own. I couldn't care less. You see, I know the God that I'm serving. God gave you prophecy. I was praying the other day with my pastor, with some brothers in the Lord. As soon as we are praying, God revealed me something about a man we are praying for. That is what I'm telling you. God can never leave you in darkness. Amen. And then talk about the spirit of discernment. God will give you the spirit of discernment. You can come here and tell me. You can speak good English. You can speak all this drama, vocabulary. It's not going to affect me. Why? Because I had the spirit of God telling me that I should never listen to unbelievers. So I have a discerning spirit. I listen to the spirit of God. I listen to the word of God, you see. And then talk about speaking in tongues. I can speak in tongues. Have you not heard? My pastor lay a hand on me. I start busting out speaking in tongues. I can speak in tongues. Why? Because the devil is confused. The devil is confused.com. He can never know the speaking of tongues. Remember the tall Babel, when God put kind of, they start speaking different kind of tongues, they all get confused. The same way today, when you speak in tongues, devil will get confused. The same way you can speak in tongues, the same way the Bible says he can also interpret of tongues. These are all the gifts God is giving you to the world to equip you. Amen. And that's the number 7. And then I talk about number 8, work of the Holy Spirit. The Bible says the spirit of empowerment. In the Acts chapter 1 verse 8, it says, but when you receive power, when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will bear witness in Jerusalem, in Judea, in Samaria, all over the world. That also includes suffering. Amen. That's what I'm telling you. Listen, you have one Holy Spirit, you have one that dwells in you, and then you have the one to empower you. So that you can go and bear witness. That is why I could come here to preach to you. I can look at your lovely faces. I'm not intimidated by any of you. I'm not intimidated by any man or woman included. I'm not intimidated by devil. Because why? I've been empowered. Amen. To preach the good news. It's I've been empowered to witness. That is why I can come here every day to preach to you. It's not by my own power. You see, that is why the Bible says you receive power. to bear witness. Amen. All over the world, you see. Hallelujah. What a wonderful God that we are serving. You see, what a mighty God. He elevates you to do what? To go to a different level, to change gear. You see, he changed gear. I mean, he make you to become practical. Amen. He equip you in every area of your life, he empower you. What a miracle working God that we are serving. And now this brings me to the ninth work of the Holy Spirit, which is the Bible says in the book of Ephesians chapter 5 verse 18. It says that to be filled with the Holy Spirit. He said be filled. So that means when you are filled, you are fully loaded with the Holy Spirit, you are being impregnated by the Holy Spirit, you are being empowered by the Holy Spirit, you have the Holy Spirit dwelling in you, you have been filled, you have power. Amen. You have been filled. So that means you lack nothing. No more excuses. You cannot go and give God excuse to sin. Why? Because you have been filled with the Holy Spirit. And what a wonderful God that we are serving. You see? So all of us need the Spirit of the Holy Spirit. Because when he equips you, you become the person that God wants you to become. You see? And he brings everything. Everything will become so clear to you. Amen. Everything is so clear to me. I know in this life anymore that money is pointless. In a sense whereby I don't have to love money. I need money to buy things that you need, but I'm not looking beyond like the worldly people now. They are willing to go and commit crime just to make money. They are willing to go to the extra mile to do other things to make money. Why? Because they have not been filled with the Holy Spirit. You see, it is more clear to me now. I know what God wants me to do. I just want to serve God. Why? Because God has empowered me. God has given me the gift of the Holy Spirit. I can say no to worldly things, and I say yes to earthly things. Amen. Some people used to say somebody become earthly worthless. I couldn't care less. Amen. I want to be heavenly worthful. Amen. Heaven used me to the Almighty God. And that is why I'm telling you today to do what? To give your life to Jesus Christ. Because I've given you the nine works of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The first one, the Holy Spirit come to do what? To convict you of your sin, righteousness and judgment. He empowers you, he dwells in you, he fills you, he gives you fruit of the Spirit, he gives you this gift of the Spirit as well. He gives you all these things to do what? To enable you so that you can live a holy and righteous life, you see. And that is why you need that helper called the Holy Spirit. Now here comes the negative that some of you don't want to hear. Now listen to what the Bible says in the book of Galatians chapter 5 verse 19. He said, now here the works of the flesh are evident: sexual immorality, impurity, sexuality, adultery, sorcery, enmity, strife, jealousy, fit of anger, rivals, decisions, divisions, envy, drunkenness, orgies. He said, all these things, I warn you, as I warned you before, that those who live such ways will not inherit the kingdom of God. Now, this is why you need that gift of the Holy Spirit. Because if you don't have the gift of the Holy Spirit, that is why you're doing boyfriend and girlfriend, which God said it is a sin for you to sleep around. You see, that is why people enter to prostitution. That is why some pastors can zip up their pants. That's why some people in a marriage, they can't be faithful to their wife or to their husband. But then the Bible won't say about purity. You see, that is why you can see people come and turn to tell me that they talk from man to woman and woman to man. That's why you have gay. That's why you have pedophile. That's why you have media in the society. Why? Because these people are not filled with the Holy Spirit. The Bible has given us the evidence of the work of the flesh. You see? And another one is what? Sexuality, adultery. That could be your mobile phone. That could be your food. That could be your smoking habit. That could be your drunkenness. That could be your drugs addiction. That could be anything that you have put before God. That could be people who are shopping all days. That could be people who spend so much time in the gym without acknowledging God. So in all these things, this adultery not just only mean when you go and worship Virgin Mary, you have the statue, that's adultery as well. But adultery can go in different many ways. God is warning you today. You see, because those people who live this kind of lifestyle cannot inherit the kingdom of God. It turns out by surgery, people have to go spend all their time in drugs. It's warning you. You're addicted to drugs, stop doing it because God don't want you to live that lifestyle. You see, the Bible says be filled with the Holy Spirit. Amen. It turns out by enmity. Do you have enmity in your life? You need to repent. God says you should love. Amen. The Bible also says love your enemy, and not only that, he says pray for them. Amen. And then talking about drunkenness, I mean, do you like to get drunk? The word of God is warning you today. The Bible says, don't get drunk with wine, but filled with the Holy Spirit. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 30. You see? And then talking about the urges, people have to go beyond. You see? Some people sleep with animals. Some people start acting like animals. Some people start acting different kind of weird ways. The word of God is warning you today. It talking about, it said, then it says, it warned you these things. And it said, it warned you before. And he's warning you again that those who live such ways will not inherit the kingdom of God. Amen. Now that is why God asked me today to preach to you about the Holy Spirit. Now you are in a new year. You need a Holy Spirit to enable you to live away from the worldly life, in this sinful world, in this adulterous and wicked generation. The Bible says that if you ask God the gift of the Holy Spirit, he will give to you. You see, that's why Jesus Christ said in the book of John 14, verse 16, he said, I will ask the Father, and he will give you another helper. He will be with you forever. Amen. He said, even the Spirit of the truth, whom the world cannot receive, because neither they see him, nor they know him. You know him, for he dwells with you, and he will be with you. I will not forsake you. I will not leave you as an orphan. I will come with you. Amen. What a wonderful God that we are serving, that he gave us the gift of the Holy Spirit, that we are not being left as orphans. He brings everything to remember us, to us. He feeds us, he empowers us. We can say no to evil. We can say yes to the Lord, and we can worship God from our heart, not from our lips. And that is why I come here today to preach to you, for you to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Because without the gift of the Holy Spirit, you cannot see God, and you cannot know God, and you need that gift of the Holy Spirit. Because when all said and done, God can say, you belongs to me, because why you have been saved with the Holy Spirit for the day of redemption. Remain blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus is Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Amen and amen and amen.